Good afternoon and welcome. Please be seated. I am Sister Barbara Reed, President of Catholic Theological Union, and it is my great pleasure, on behalf of our students, staff, faculty, and Board of Trustees, to welcome you to our 54th annual commencement ceremony. We are here not only to celebrate our graduates' impressive academic achievements, but also to give thanks for their families, friends, and communities who have supported them through their journey, and to pray that the Holy One will continue to accompany them in their myriad ministries as they disperse throughout the globe. We are grateful to Rabbi Reeves and his staff who have warmly welcomed us into their beautiful worship space, resuming a long tradition of friendship with KAM Isaiah Israel, begun with Rabbi Chaim Perlmutter of blessed memory, who led this congregation and was a founding member of CTU's faculty. We are delighted to welcome Reverend our dear friend Agbonkiamenhe Orobator of the Society of Jesus, who will receive an honorary doctorate in theology, and Sister Teresa Maya of the Sisters of Charity of the Incarnate Word, who will be awarded an honorary doctorate in ministry. Welcome to all. And let us join now in prayer. Faithful and loving God, in this special year in which celebrations of Easter, Passover, and Ramadan all converged, we pray that our one God continue to unite all peoples and lead us in pathways to peace. We thank you for the gift of your powerful Spirit, who hovered over the chaos at the dawn of creation and brought forth life in all its abundance and variety. Help us to recognize you in all the beauty of earth, in one another, and in all creatures. We thank you for the gift of the Christ, who became one with us, revealing your saving love and faithfulness. Help us to follow him in our words and actions. We thank you for the gift of the vivifying Spirit, who turned frightened followers of Jesus into powerful preachers and teachers and healers. As we heal from the global pandemic and from the effects of war and hatred, help us to follow the Spirit's promptings toward renewal and oneness. We pray this in gratitude and hope. Amen. And now I invite you to stand and join in our hymn.
Please be seated. Good afternoon. I am Roger Schrader, Interim Vice President and Academic Dean at Catholic Theological Union. It is my privilege to guide us through these 54th annual commencement exercises. I'd like to begin by adding my own words of welcome to those of President Barbara Reed, to those of you present, and those of you joining us via Zoom. I'd like to offer a few words to our graduates. This is a special graduation in several ways. First, we could have an in-person and stream graduation for the first time in 3 years. That's a good thing. Secondly, we are back to our traditional venue for CTU graduations at the beautiful KAM Isaiah Israel Synagogue. And thirdly, we are not only celebrating the graduates of a single year, but we also invited back the graduates of 2020 and 2021 to join us in person. For all of you graduates, your academic and life journey has been quite unique due to the challenges related to COVID, the suffering of the peoples around the world and of our planet, and our renewed call to combat racism and all forms of prejudice. At the same time, the past few years have also brought us opportunities of connecting synchronously, asynchronously, and bimodally with professors and fellow students around the country and the world, with whom you would not have had such encounters under face-to-face circumstances. To the graduates of 2022, 2021, and 2020, you deserve special words of congratulations as you prepare to go out to serve God's people in a variety of ways. I now invite your chosen spokesperson, Emily Davis, graduating with a Master of Divinity degree, to address us on behalf of the graduates.
When I look out at this room, I am like tremendously humbled and honored to be the one standing before you giving this address today. There is a certain kind of magic at CTU. Many moments where in the midst of our coursework, the Holy Spirit stops us in our tracks. I have a specific memory of unpacking the final chapter of John's Gospel, where the disciples encounter the risen Jesus, and Peter is gifted with a redo of his threefold denial. Jesus will ask Peter 3 times, "Do you love me?" And each time, Peter will respond, "Lord, you know that I love you." To which Jesus will offer the triple command, "Feed my sheep, tend my lambs, feed my sheep." As we reflected on this moment in our course, as people preparing for ministry, we focused mostly on the command. And yet, as the conversation evolved, we turned to the question that preceded Jesus' command, "Do you love me?" At this point, our conversation dramatically shifted, and we were left sort of stunned. In the midst of the love for feeding sheep, we were questioning what it meant to be in touch with the essential relationship that had called us to ministry in the first place. And in exploring this even more, we realized we had many answers to "Do you love me?" But all of them were about actions or behaviors, something that can be measured or seen. Praying a certain number of times a day, the commitment we made to serve in a particular ministry, our prophetic justice work on behalf of those on the margins. And while all those things were certainly important and a part of what it meant to be people called to ministry, we were really struck with why Jesus would ask, "Do you love me?" Jesus led with his relationship with Peter. He did not ask, "Can you help me?" Or even at this moment, "Will you follow me?" At one of the last moments we have of Jesus before his ascension, he will ask, "Do you love me? Feed my lambs." For many of us graduating today, we began our time at CTU pre-pandemic. Our journey to this moment has been marked by significant change and in a lot of ways, trauma. And I think as the pandemic has continued, our world has come to a particular reckoning moment with all that might have already been infected. To name a few, we've seen the virus of othering, greed, exploitation, polarization, racism, antisemitism, xenophobia, hatred, and violence tear through communities and even take lives. In the church, we find ourselves fractured. Who is worthy of communion? What does marriage mean? Which voices are heard? And which voices are silent? We find ourselves shaken awake by this global pandemic, newly aware of the immensity of human suffering and sickness. Pope Francis is called to be a field hospital, becoming all the more poignant. And so I want to take us back to that beach. Do you love me? Tend my sheep. What has impacted me most in my time at CTU is that in theology and ministry, context and human experience matter. This is because ultimately none of us are solitary beings. While we have a unique identity, it is shaped from the context that we come from and continues to be impacted by what we are surrounded by. In the context of ministry, as noticed in the moment I mentioned, any kind of call to Christian mission and ministry begins with this essential relationship. Do you love me? Feed my sheep. Mother Teresa says, if we have no peace, it is because we have forgotten that we belong to one another. And so can we return to this beach where the risen Jesus and Peter recall this sense of belonging? Can this moment where a traumatized disciple is transformed into one of the most prominent leaders in the early church inspire us to face the trauma, the suffering, the virus, with the hope that relationship and belonging might ultimately be the path to Pentecost, the path where our service begins and where the Holy Spirit does the most important work? As we all leave this moment where we celebrate the journey we have completed, as we enter this world that is troubled, how do we remember this belonging? How do we embody the kind of tenderness and transformative kinship that truly feeds the sheep? I think we must begin by recognizing the love we already belong to. I am grateful to belong to a long line of powerful, wild women that have taught me what it meant to live a life full of compassionate fire, and a parish community that believed in the lay minister I would become. We are all here because of those who have been committed to our flourishing as human persons, who taught us what it meant to belong in the first place. Those in our communities of faith that created space for us to practice what we were learning and were patient with our shortcomings. those here at CTU, the faculty and staff that have planted seeds within us that will continue to bloom as we enter this world of full-time ministry. And finally, all of the generous financial benefactors who believe that the world is better with strong theological education and preparation for ministry. These people are our sheep feeders and lamb tenders. People who are loved, love. And so how do we take this incredible gift of an education and use it to love? How do we remind the world that we all belong to one another? We do this by being a church first of belonging, a community marked by kinship and sharing, open-hearted relationships rather than systems and programs. We remember that ministry is about service. We value loving the other most, and we lead with the humility this requires. Ordination, religious vows, and ministry job titles are ultimately commitments to surrender, not positions of power to be wielded. And finally, we embrace the chaos that comes from love. We honor the subjectivity of those around us. We trust in their conscience. We model our creative energy after the ultimate creator, privileging freedom in love over power and control. And so as we move from here today, let us always remember that ultimately we begin with, do you love me? Thank you.
Thank you very much, Emily. It is now my privilege and my pleasure to present to you the graduating class of 2022. And also this year, I'm happy to add some graduates from 2020 and 2021 virtual ceremonies. You have been able to join us here today. We ask that you hold your applause to the end, especially for the sake of those students whose family and friends are at a distance and who cannot be in person to cheer them on. Certificates. Will the candidates for certificates please stand and come forward? Our first graduates of the evening are receiving certificates. Six areas of concentration are represented by today's graduates. Catholic Theological Union offers a variety of certificates. Students in these programs design their course of studies either to prepare for a new ministry or to enhance their effectiveness in a current one. Receiving a certificate in biblical ministry, Brian Hansen. Receiving a certificate in Black Theology and Ministry, Stephanie B. Garrison. Receiving a certificate in Hispanic Theology and Ministry, Vicente del Real Alvarez. Philip Dolan, CP. Receiving a certificate in Intercultural Studies and Ministry, Tracy Watson in Abstentia. Receiving a certificate in Mission Studies, Carl Edward Gales, SVD. Derek Nguyen. Tring C. Nguyen, OFM CAP, in Abstentia. John Siyumbu, in Abstentia. Receiving a certificate in Pastoral Studies, Gerber Felix, SVD, in absentia. Visval Joseph, SVD, in absentia. Neil Pavo, in absentia. Spencer Thomas. Master of Arts in Specialized Ministries and Master of Arts in Pastoral Studies. CTU offers 7 Masters of Arts in Specialized Ministries, Master of Arts in Biblical Ministry, Hispanic Theology and Ministry, Intercultural Studies and Ministry, Justice Ministry, Liturgical Ministry, Masters in Ministry, Spiritual Ministry, and a Master of Arts in Pastoral Studies. Will the candidates for the Masters of Arts in Specialized Ministries and a Master of Arts in Pastoral Studies please stand and come forward. The Master of Arts in Biblical Ministry is a professional program of specialized study focused on giving students the knowledge and skills needed to conduct biblical ministry in a variety of settings, usually on the parish level. Receiving the degree of Master's of Arts in Biblical Ministry, Yolanda Cortez, 2021. Brother Mark N. Palikawan, SVD. Master of Arts in Hispanic Theology and Ministry. The Master of Arts in Hispanic Theology and Ministry equips students for competent pastoral leadership in accompanying the variety of communities that fall under the broad demographic categories of Latino and Hispanic in the context of the United States of America. Receiving a degree of Master's of Arts in Hispanic Theology and Ministry, Teresa Juarez, 2021. Ariadna Lizeth Nunez Martinez. Master of Arts in Intercultural Studies and Ministry. The Master of Arts in Intercultural Studies and Ministry is designed to prepare ministers to serve in settings with a diversity of cultural groups interfacing with and impacting one another. Receiving a degree of Master of Arts in Intercultural Studies and Ministry, Stephanie Kwawi Nene Sharifatau Gado, 2020. Barbara Ann Linick, 2021. In Yong Oh. Catherine Solano in absentia. Esther Uyoseji, 2020. Master of Arts in Justice Ministry. The Master of Arts in Justice Ministry is a professional program of specialized study designed to prepare ministers to deal with theological and pastoral issues related to environmental justice, racial justice, reconciliation, and social justice. Receiving the degree of Master of Arts in Justice Ministry, Maria Isabel Hernandez Salazar, 2021. Master of Arts in Liturgical Ministry. The Master of Arts in Liturgical Ministry is a professional program of specialized study designed to give students the knowledge and skills to exercise liturgical leadership in a parish setting. Receiving a degree of Master of Arts in Liturgical Ministry, Larry Barton, in absentia. Master of Arts in Ministry. A Master of Arts in Ministry is a professional degree designed to allow beginning or seasoned ministers an opportunity to delve more deeply into an area of their intended or existing ministry. Receiving the degree of Masters of Arts in Ministry, Hermes Haddad. Receiving a degree of Master of Arts in Spiritual Ministry, Susan Barber, OSB 2020 in Abstentia. Master of Arts in Pastoral Studies. The Master of Arts in Pastoral Studies is a professional program of study designed particularly for those who already have fairly extensive experience in ministry. In the MAPS program, students range across the breadth of theological disciplines while at the same time having the opportunity to focus on particular areas of ministry. Receiving a degree of Master of Arts in Pastoral Ministry, Sister Chioma Ahaniu SLW in Abstentia. Verma J. Barker Hill, 2020. Annette Batista Colin Chip. Jennifer Corliss Reed, 2020. Vicente Del Real Alvarez. Catherine R. Fraser, OP. Stephanie B. Garrison. Marcial Gomez, 2020. Mary Ellen Harrington, 2021. Shamar O. Hemphill. Melissa Marie Judah. Evelyn Tiamoa. Myra Price. David J. Relsop. Michael Collins Shannon. Juan F. Soto, 2021. Michael James Specht in Abstentia, Patricia A. Sullivan in Abstentia. Master of Arts in Theology. Will the candidates for the Master of Arts in Theology please stand and come forward? The Master of Arts in Theology is an academic degree. CTU offers two such masters: the General Academic MA, which prepares students for teaching theology at the secondary or college level, and the Research MA, which readies students for entry into doctoral programs in theology. Receiving the degree of Masters of Arts in Theology, Augustin Carrillo, Jr. Jennifer Lynn Duvall. Congratulations, Jennifer. Jonathan W. Emanuelson. Brian Hansen. Fang Liu. Catherine O'Brien in absentia. Herbert Kinde Valderuten, 2020. Guy James Valponi in absentia. Master of Divinity. Will the candidates for the Master of Divinity please stand and come forward? The Master of Divinity degree is a professional degree preparing candidates for ordained ministry and for pastoral leadership in the church. CTU's MDiv curriculum invites students to develop an integrative and interdisciplinary approach to theology while still having the opportunity to focus on a particular theological area. Receiving the degree of Master of Divinity, Dominic Avila Smith in absentia, Yanina Castilla Rojas, 2020. Cici Chen. Ramon Peter Chinapan in absentia, Alessandro Contreras, OSA, 2021. Emily Davis. Philip Dolan, CP. Gregory John Evers, CPPS. Carl Edward Gales, SVD. Emmanuel Isaac, OSA, in absentia. Abraham Saramu Joseph, 2020. Norberto Mendina Jr., CMF. Brother Antonio Julius Milton, OFM CAP, in absentia. Derek Nguyen. Tring C. Nguyen, OFM CAP, in absentia. Linda Christine Novak. Victor Perez, ST. Francisco Santoso, SVD, 2021. Theo M. Sima Tupang, 2021. John Siyumbu in absentia, Spencer Thomas. Jonathan F. Turba, OPREM. Doctor of Ministry. Will the candidates for the Doctor of Ministry please stand? The Doctor of Ministry is an advanced professional degree open to those who hold a master's degree, Master of Divinity, and who have such sustained experience in ministry. The Doctor of Ministry program helps candidates to reflect out of that experience and its cultural context, and in conversation with the Christian tradition, to hone the skills needed to form other leaders in ministry. A major component of the DMN program is the elaboration of a thesis project. This evening, after calling the candidate forward, I will announce the title of the thesis project and invite the faculty member who worked with the candidate in its shaping and writing to bestow the doctoral hood. Receiving the Doctor of Ministry, Stanley Alex Augustine. His thesis project is entitled Spiritual Practices in Finding Meaning in Life Among Tamil Sri Lankan Refugees. Director Scott Alexander. Brother Rodney Bowers, SVD. His thesis project is entitled Forming Healthy Priests in a Time of Crisis and Uncertainty. Director Steve Bevins, SVD, for Robin Ryan, CP. Elia S. Cardenas, her thesis project is entitled Praxis of Accompaniamiento to the Pueblo Creyente Towards an Inclusive, Liberative, and Decolonized Pastoral Model as a Gift to the Universal Church. Director Aruko Doy, M.M. Rachel Kramer, class of 2020. Her thesis project was entitled Towards a Holistic Education, Forging Integrative Approaches Between Campus Ministers and Theology Faculty at Catholic Universities. Director Ed Foley, OFM Cap. Eugenia Wei Quen Lai. Her thesis project is entitled Asian Immigrant Women Building Spiritual Resilience Amidst Cultural Loss. Director Aruko Doy, M.M. Eileen B. Maggiore, class of 2020. Her thesis project was entitled Visio Divina in Light of the USCCB Curriculum Framework. Director Richard Fragomini. Thank you. Andre Sudol, SCJ, class of 2021. His thesis project was entitled Challenges and Opportunities of Initial Formation for Interculturality in a Congregation of the Priests of the Sacred Heart in the United States Province. Director Roger Schrader, SVD. Together, let us now acknowledge all our graduates of 2022, as well as those of 2020, 21. This evening's graduates have worked intensely to hone their skills in theological thinking and ministerial practice, but they have not done this alone. Their communities, families, friends, formation directors, and fellow ministers have given them unfailing support. I ask all those community and family members, friends, formation directors, fellow ministers who have played a part behind the scenes in supporting today's graduates to please stand, whether you're in person or if you're on Zoom, as we express our appreciation for all your sacrifices and encouragement. I also ask the staff members of CTU, those who have accompanied the graduates from the time they first inquired about studies at CTU, those who helped them through the admissions process, who registered them for classes, and helped them get loans and scholarships and pay their bills, and all who have provided student services in myriad of ways, to stand and be recognized. In addition, our alumni are crucial to us in their continuing support of CTU and encouraging others to stay here. Would all those who are CTU alums please stand and let us express our appreciation to you. Some of the members of our Board of Trustees are present this evening. We ask our trustees to stand as we express our appreciation for your support and oversight of CTU. Finally, key companions in guiding the learning process of tonight's graduates are an extraordinary group of scholars. Through their teaching, research, writing, mentoring, guiding, the faculty give of themselves selflessly year in and year out. I invite the faculty of Catholic Theological Union to stand and be recognized. The two final degrees this evening are honorary degrees. However, have no doubt they have been well earned. Our recipients this evening have distinguished themselves by committed service in a variety of areas which have touched and transformed the lives of many. Our first honorary degree is a Doctorate of Theology. It is awarded to a person whose research and teaching, either in formal settings or through their lifestyle, deepen in others an awareness and understanding of the mystery of our loving God. Today's recipient of the honorary doctorate in theology is Reverend Abogi Amehe, E. Arobator, S.J. I now invite Ferdinand Okore, CMF, Assistant Professor of New Testament Studies, Director of the Biblical Studies and Travel Program, and Vice President and Academic Dean-Elect, to read a citation. President Barbara Reed will then confer the degree.
Reverend Abonki Amege E. Orobato is a Catholic priest from Nigeria and a professed member of the Society of Jesus since 1986. Among the many hats he concurrently wears are president of the Jesuit Conference of Africa and Madagascar, founder and director of the African Synodality Initiative, Chancellor of Arupe Jesuit University in Harare, Zimbabwe, consultant to the Lambeth Palace Advisory Team on Peace and Reconciliation in South Sudan, and vice chair of the Board of Directors of Georgetown University in Washington, D.C. He previously served as president, principal, and lecturer at Hakima University College, Jesuit School of Theology in Nairobi, Kenya, and the Institute of Peace Studies and International Relations. He also held the position of Provincial Superior of the Eastern African Province of the Society of Jesus, covering Kenya, Uganda, Tanzania, Ethiopia, Sudan, and South Sudan from 2009 to 2014. He obtained his doctorate in theology and religious studies from the University of Leeds in England in 2004. His dissertation was approved without correction. Thus far, he has received two honorary degrees, Doctor of Law from Fairfield University, Connecticut, and the Doctor of Divinity, Santa Clara University Jesuit School of Theology, Berkeley. A systematic and contextual theologian of the First Order. He authored books including The Pope and the Pandemic, Lessons in Leadership in a Time of Crisis, 2021. Religion and Faith in Africa, 2018. And that book is the winner of the 2019 Catholic Press Association Book Award. And Theology Brewed in an African Pot. I love that one. 2008. An exceptional contribution to the development of an African inculturated theology. Thus, these, among with numerous edited books and articles, have been mainstays in theological bibliographies across continents. An internationally sought after speaker, Father Roberto graciously served as invited guest lecturer at Catholic Theological Union on two occasions. From Creation to Salvation and Back, Ecology Brewed in an African Pot, for the 2016 Historical and Doctrinal Studies Lecture, and also Those Who Neither Lay Nor Hatch Eggs, the call of religious life in Africa for the Center for the Study of Consecrated Life 2015 conference on the global call of the religious life today. In addition, he delivered a lecture, Religion of Underdevelopment, Practice versus Performance in Africa, for DePaul University Center for World Catholicism and Intercultural Theology in 2014. It is also worth mentioning that his cousin, Sister Anna Arobame, Associate Director of the Faber Center for Ignatian Spirituality at Marquette University, is an alumna of Catholic Theological Union, DMIN 2011, and his mother, Mama Rosalyn Orobato, has been a resident of Chicago for years. For his many contributions as an esteemed African theologian, global educator, and wisdom figure, the faculty and board of trustees of Catholic Theological Union are proud to confer on Reverend Abonki Amehe Orobato the degree of Doctor of Theology honoris causa.
President Barbara Reed, fellow honoree Sister Teresa Meyer, Chair and Trustees of Catholic Theological Union, faculty, staff, and formation directors, and most especially our honored graduates. In the culture where I grew up, parents and adult members indulged in a curious habit of creating fictional beings called otutu for the sole purpose of frightening children into good behavior and deterring them from unethical behavior. Otutu could be anything from a hideously humanoid insect to a terrifying ogre. And looking back, Otutu resembled a cross between C.S. Lewis's Screwtape and Alfred Lord Tennyson's nature personified red in tooth and claw. Now, although like the Loch Ness Monster, no sighting of Hutuhutu was ever confirmed, once the specter had been evoked and conjured up, it held sway over our imagination. It sufficed for parents and adults to pronounce the name Hutuhutu, and children would scamper for safety. Hutuhutu always prowls in the dark, sinister in intent, malevolent in deed. To this day, Hutuhutu comes to mind when I think of the carnage and barbarity of nonsensical trench warfare in Yemen, Ethiopia, Ukraine. When I think of the agonizing devastation of a virus that has taken 15 million lives and counting, or of the profoundly shocking tragedy of a teenager who travels 200 miles intent on taking as many black lives as possible, and another teenager who walks into an elementary school and guns down innocent school children and their teachers. I think of Hutuhutu when I remember terrorists who randomly abduct, abuse, and murder schoolgirls to gratify their idols of hypocrisy and criminality, or of communities in Ethiopia, Kenya, and Somalia, where one person dies every 48 seconds from acute hunger linked to conflict, climate change, and the rising cost of food. Such cruel assaults on human lives are the depressingly familiar Hutuhutu of our times that hurt, distort, and violate the dignity of each person created in the image and likeness of our God. Happily today, in this sacred space, in Catholic Theological Union, we are witnessing a different reality as we celebrate the graduating class of 2022. Friends, by your accomplishment, you offer a different vision for our world. As the proud samples of this globally recognized academic institution, imbued with an ecumenical spirit, powered by collaboration, and designed for theological and ministerial excellence in the church and in the world. Unlike Hutuhutu, you are women and men formed in the spirit of CTU, ready to serve and minister as witnesses to Christ's good news of justice, love, and peace. Congratulations. Back to my story. As children, we soon discovered that the best way to counter the menace of Hutuhutu was to never walk alone and to always carry a lantern. If you asked another child to walk with you and hold a lantern, together you could defeat even the most ferocious Hutuhutu. And that way, we validated the wisdom that when ants act together, they can tie up a lion. Esteemed graduates, wherever you go, dare to be partners in mission and emissaries of light. Like my fellow honoree, Sister Maya, who excels as a bridge builder and a change agent, be artisans of a different future where no Otutu can hide or prowl. President Reed, dear graduates, and the entire CTU family, I gratefully and humbly accept this honorary doctorate degree in theology and the consequent duty of partnering in the mission of CTU to co-create a world free of Otutu and shaped by the values of the gospel of Jesus Christ. Thank you. Congratulations.
Our second honorary degree is a doctorate in ministry. This degree is awarded to persons who have distinguished themselves through the style and impact of the ministry they perform for the people of God. Today's recipient of the honorary doctorate in ministry is Sister Teresa Maya of the Sisters of Charity of the Incarnate Word. I invite Haruko Doi, MM, Associate Professor of Intercultural Studies and Ministry, to come forward to read the citation. President Barbara Reed will then confer the degree.
It is a delight to confer upon Sister Teresa Maya, CCVI, the title of Doctor of Ministry, honoris causa. Sister Teresa Maya is first and foremost a Sister of Charity of the Incarnate Word. She is grounded in the Incarnate Word of God. From this understanding, her vocation and life emanate as a living witness to her congregation's refrain, "Praised be the Incarnate Word." Sister Teresa's educational journey includes undergraduate studies at Yale in history and a master's degree in systematic theology at the Graduate Theological Union. Her doctoral studies at El Colegio de Mexico led her to Latin American history, linking theology as she researched and wrote about the Catholic Church in colonial Mexico. Her studies offered local, regional, and international perspectives, and her ministry embraced all these areas in ever-widening horizons for the church and consecrated life. In Mexico, her country of origin, Sister Teresa's work in education of youth led her to create networks for the schools to join in sharing resources of all kinds, impacting students, faculty, staff, and administration at all levels. Sister Teresa is, in her own words, committed to ministry and education and to the formation of pastoral agents for ministries in the United States, Mexico, Chile, Peru, and Colombia. This is also manifested in the courses she offers in graduate programs in Hispanic ministry, including working with the Association of Theological Schools on programs for Hispanic graduate students in theology and for the people of God to learn more about a church that encompasses an incredible diversity of cultures. As she completes her service in elected leadership for the Sisters of Charity of the Incarnate Word congregation, one sees beauty in the call to service to her congregation, where she has served as counselor for 4 years and congregational leader for 8 years. Leadership has included service as president of the Leadership Conference of Women Religious. Additionally, Sister Teresa offers her vision to other conferences of religious, including the Conference of Religious of Latin America, Union of International Superiors General, Conference of Religious of Peru, and Conference of Religious of Mexico. Her service to an even wider church includes words of encouragement and challenges. Addressing crowds at the Los Angeles Religious Education Congress, she called all to witness God's mercy in the world. She also addressed the United States Conference of Catholic Bishops in their time of need, calling them to a deeper communion. There is more to come, we know, yet in this moment, the faculty and board of trustees at Catholic Theological Union, in conferring the Doctor of Ministry honoris causa, in gratitude for Sister Teresa Maya's gifts, proclaim, "Praise be the incarnated world."
Thank you to President Barbara, to the faculty at CTU, and to my new brother, Orobato. Thank you for sharing this time with me today. Graduations are always gratitude-filled moments. On behalf of my Sisters of Charity of the Incarnate Word, I thank the CTU community for this doctorate. Like my fellow graduates, I know there's no way to get to this day on your own. My sisters have given me opportunities, encouragement, and yes, an occasional critique. Without them, all the reasons offered today were impossible. Dear graduates, I pray today you will find those people, past and present, here and beyond, who have blessed you with their support over the years. We accompany and they accompany you this day. We gather in this beautiful sacred space on the threshold of so much turmoil. I confess, I was tempted to just tell you to stay in school another year or two, or get another degree. What's the rush? Perhaps the uncertainty will settle a little. Perhaps we might begin to have more clarity about what is coming. What is ours to do? Maybe one more class, another book. I realize this is not the most prophetic advice, but I also know there is nothing wrong with being afraid. Just remember to be afraid with others, never alone. I am daunted by reflecting on the moment we are called to live. The aftermath of a global pandemic, war on many fronts around the world, including Ukraine. The climate crisis threatening our common home. An economy of disposable human beings. Ridiculous resistance to diversity. A culture of polarization where our civil discourse is more and more endangered. And today, especially, I come from Texas. The growing tragedies of gun violence intersecting with a mental health national crisis. I want to take a breath and sit with the sadness and vulnerability of our human family. I am indeed tempted to despair. Why now? Why us? How do we come together? And even sometimes, God, where are you? Where are you? What is ours to do and what is yours to do with this new degree? With the call to serve in ministry in different and varying forms, I offer you my image, one I return to often. I believe more than ever, this is a time for bridge building. Bridges fascinate me. I lived in the Bay Area when the 1989 earthquake damaged the Bay Bridge, disconnecting the two sides of the bay. I enjoyed every trip back there watching how, even in the United States, it took 20 years to get a new bridge. What difficult, complicated, and dangerous work. Bridge building is an art. They require engineering and precision, but also design flexibility and a lot of collaboration. And as we learned in the Bay Area, a lot of politics. Building bridges is a dangerous task. Many people die constructing them. Smaller bridges connect in little places, and temporary bridges require speed and ingenuity. And then there are other kinds of bridges. Bridges that connect cultures and peoples. Translators are bridge builders. Even software like Zoom can serve as a bridge. And aren't you a Zoom generation? I have learned bridges are built beginning from opposite ends, and that connecting them is the last part of the project. And I have also learned that destroying bridges is a key strategy of war. How many of us were horrified by the images of thousands of people crossing destroyed bridges on foot in Ukraine? Bridges, great and small, need to claim our imagination. Bridges of all kinds have created opportunities for encounter and relationships. Bridges have been the heart of debates and wars. Bridges have also sparked the imagination of artists. And we need to build many bridges. Argentinian writer Elsa Isabel Bornemann, who challenged the dictatorship with a children's book, writes about drawing bridges. Her poem, Puentes, continues to inspire me. Yo dibujo puentes para que me encuentres. I draw bridges so you can find me. Y tú, quien creyera, no los ves siquiera. Hago 110-1, no cruzas ninguno. Mas, como te quiero, dibujo y espero. Bellos puentes, para que me encuentres. And you who would know, you don't even see them. I draw 110-1. Yet, because I love you, I draw and wait. Beautiful bridges, so you might find me. We draw bridges because we love. This is our mission as ministers of the reign of God. Our particular kind of bridge building requires collaboration and dialogue to kindle, nourish, build, encourage, and foster unity in community. As committed people of faith, we must engage in the art of bridge building because we know we are called to be one. We must understand that bridge building is not enough, though. You can build bridges, but not everyone crosses them. But true, if there is no bridge, even fewer people will cross. And here's another inspiration from Shel Silverstein. He writes in The Bridge, "But this bridge will only take you halfway there. The last few steps you'll have to take alone." Silverstein is right. We might build the bridges, but we cannot make anyone cross them. Yet this should not dissuade us from the critical task of bridging, because the bridge needs to be there for people to cross. Furthermore, I offer that a well-made bridge entices one to cross. That is why Uruguayan Mario Benedetti writes, "Ahí está el puente, para cruzarlo o para no cruzarlo. Yo lo voy a cruzar sin prevenciones. There is the bridge, to be crossed or not, I will cross without hesitation." Building bridges cannot be a choice for us, but crossing always is. Let's build and cross, build and cross. And graduates, please build bridges to places you don't want to go, to communities you don't want to meet, to ideas and theologies you might be suspicious of. Build the bridges and cross them. The future of humanity demands new architects who will create the bridges that will save us and our planet. Build bridging has to be a skill of anyone in ministry today. You are the architects, the engineers, and the artists who will bridge, who will cross, and who will invite others to come. CTU graduates of all the classes of 2020, 2021, and 2022, let's go build bridges, great and small. Amen.
Thank you very much, Terry. Now we have completed the academic portion of these commencement exercises, we are invited to spend the remaining minutes in prayer. Let us begin our prayer with song, "Please Stand."
Grow.
As you have prayed for us, you can turn back this way now, okay? As you have prayed for us, so we would like to pray for you and send you forth with God's blessing. I invite the members of the assembly and those on Zoom to turn toward the graduates to extend your hands in blessing as President Reed confers the commissioning prayer.
Before we pray our prayer for the graduates, I would like to add one more expression of thanks. Professor Roger Schrader, who has been guiding us through this ceremony today, generously put his own teaching and research on a back burner to step into the role of interim vice president and academic dean in January 2021. What he thought would be 6 months turned into 18. His competent leadership and his great listening heart have been enormous gifts to the CTU community at a time of transition. As Roger returns to the full-time faculty responsibilities, we are most confident that with Roger's guidance and the support of all the faculty and staff and students and everybody at CTU, our new dean, Ferdinand de Corrier, will lead us well into the next years. But please join me in thanking Roger for his generous service. Let us extend our hands in prayer over the graduates. Gracious and loving God, you who have formed each of us and all creation in your love, transform us by your word and set us aflame by your spirit. Pour out your choicest blessings on these your graduates as they go forth to serve you and your people. Give them the courage of Sarah and Abraham, as when you called them to journey with you into the unknown. Give them the receptivity of Samuel and Mary, who responded to your call, "Here I am, I come to do your will." Give comfort to them at times of discouragement, as you did with Elijah when he curled up under a broom tree and wanted to die. Give them delight, as you did with Elizabeth and Zechariah, when they were ready to abandon hope in the promise of new life. Help them be faithful, as was Job, even when it seemed like everything was being taken away. Give them boldness in proclaiming your word, as you did with Mary Magdalene on Easter morning. And forgive them, as you did Peter, when he denied he even knew you, and let them feel the balm of your mercy each time they start afresh. And finally, guide them to recreate the world with you, staying ever close to Emmanuel, God with us, and set them afire by your powerful spirit. And at the end of their journey, welcome them, loving God, into the light of your eternal presence, where you live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Ours is a global church that stretches across this planet from south to north, from east to west, and as the flags behind me signify, we are a microcosm of that global church. And so let us pray for our church throughout our world in whatever language you most comfortably pray, using the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Thank you.
You're all invited to congratulate our graduates at the reception at Catholic Theological Union. Because of the proximity of former President Obama's house, just across the street, there are a few special instructions. Faculty and graduates will exit through the main doors of the temple, but I ask you not to linger on the steps of the temple or take pictures on the steps. Our guests may exit through the main doors following the graduates or through the hallway on my right, but we ask that you proceed immediately to the reception at CTU. I hereby declare these 54th annual commencement exercises in the 2021-22 academic year closed. Let us go forth in joy and thanksgiving to God. Amen.
Thank you.